And I see blood splatter look like on my wall. And I started chopping as he was coming in through the window, and I chopped, and I was telling him, chop his, chop his, chop his.
Did he say anything?
And ran. If I got to pull it out like that, I'm going to get you. But he lost some blood in there. This day he lost some blood.
I'm American Gun Chick, and you're watching American Honey Badger USA. Welcome to American Honey Badger, where we showcase the baddest women on the planet, ladies who refuse to be victims and make the hunters the hunted. This week, we are showcasing my favorite honey badger to date. She's from Memphis, Tennessee, and there is no way I could tell her story better than she does. So let's let her take it from here.
I was laying in the bed. I was watching television on my cell phone, YouTube, and I heard a couple of bumps at the door. We got three doors. It was one of the three storm doors. And so I know we got a raccoon under the house, so I figured it might have been the raccoon, but she got to have hands to hit the door. So I kind of peeked out the blinds. I didn't see anybody. So I laid back down, was finished watching YouTube. And I heard a rip. And I'm like, okay, what the hell? It's my screen. I'm laying right here in my bed, and it's the screen on my window. So I jumped up, I grabbed my cell phone, and I grabbed my machete. And I ran out the room, I ran in here, and I called 911. And I was telling the lady that somebody was breaking in the house. I said, they coming in right now. She was like, well, where are you? I said, I'm in the living room. She said, where they coming? I said, they coming in my bedroom window. I ran out of my bedroom. I didn't have this on. I was not dressed. And so I eased back down the hallway, and I stood on the far side of my bedroom window of my door. And I was looking in the bedroom to see what the progress was, and I was still talking to the lady, the police on the phone. I said, well, he just let the window up. I said, and looks like he's coming in. And I didn't want him to come in because I don't know what he had. So I had my machete, so I went into attack mode, and I started chopping as he was coming in through the window, and I chopped, and I was telling him, chop his, chop his, chop his. And then he bagged out the window, and then he went that way running. And I still had my phone, I had my machete, and I went out the back door. And when I got outside, I realized that I was not dressed. So I ran back in the house, and I put some clothes on. Then I ran back out the door, and I was chasing him down the road. And that's when the police pulled up, and she was like, well, you still got the machete in your hand? I was like, yeah. She said, well, put it on the ground, put it on the ground. So I laid the machete down, and I was still telling the police that he went that way in the neighborhood. Oh, God, I was so scared. I didn't know what to do. And then now, I go back in my room a little while ago, and I'm looking around, and I see blood splatter look like on my wall. So that's when I call the police back, so they can come out here and look to see why I chopped him. I know I hit him. I tore blinds and everything. I chopped my blinds up and everything, trying to get at this guy. So I know I hit him, and I got wet blood splatter, what's never on my wall. So they supposed to be trying to come back out and look at it, what's never this and that. But I got him. I chopped him. It's the second time he done broke in here. He broke in here right before Christmas and stole all our TVs. And so we sitting here now for Christmas with no TVs, you know, stuff missing, Christmas stuff and stuff like that was gone. And I guess he figured, you know, since the white car was gone, he was gonna come on back. And I'm saying he coming through the front window with all this traffic right here. You know, these people over here ain't even looked out the door. Ain't did nothing. Here you see a person going through a window.
Further proof that the only person that can protect you is you. Society will often turn away. And that's not something I'm willing to risk my life on. Back to the story.
He had on a whole shirt, like with the hood attached to it. And had on these black jeans and some black shoes with some white on. But I chopped him. I chopped him with my machete, I sure did.
Did he say anything?
And ran.
Have I told you how much I love this lady?
I heard him holler. That's all. And by the time that, like I said, I was going out the back door because I was going to cut him off. You're not going to get away from here. And then I realized it was cold outside. So I had to come back and put clothes on. Because I'd hate to be running down the street as the way I would, because they probably would have got me, thinking something was wrong with me. So by the time I got back out there, like I said, he was going around that White House on that corner right there. He was booking it. He was holding his pants in one hand and had his head and is trying to pull his hood over on the other hand. But if I had been dressed accordingly, I'd have caught it. I don't know if he had anything or what, you know what I'm saying? So I figured I would probably do best with the element of surprise instead of letting him surprise me by getting in here. Because once he got in here, I can't whoop a man. So, my fight probably would have been a couple of licks and I'd have been through. But, you know, just thank you, Lord. So hopefully he'll tell the rest of them, you know, whatever y'all do, don't go to that house because you might not get back out of there once you get in. And just, you know, by the grace of God, because I could have let him come on in and I could have stood in the bathroom or something and waited till he walked right past me. But I don't want to hurt anybody. I don't want to get hurt either. So I figure if I prevent him from coming in, that's going to save me and him, because I don't want to go to jail for killing nobody over no material stuff. Because I was swinging that machete. I was saying, chop his up, chop his up. I done chopped up my headboard. I done chopped up the blinds. You know the little thing what you open the blinds? Well, I chopped that sucker in half. Blinds cut in half, so I know my knife is sharp. I keep a sharp edge on it. Cause I don't got time for that. I like to hit you. If I got to pull it out like that, I'm going to get you. So long as I don't have to pull it out, I'm good to go. And I don't want a weapon because you easy to kill people with a gun. I don't want to kill nobody. But I want to maim him and make sure he understood. He gonna go get some emergency help, but he lost some blood in there. This day he lost some blood.
All right, you like to add anything that I didn't ask you?
No, I'm just glad I'm all right. You know, I hope he is all right. You know, I hope he is all right. But I also hope he learned something from this. You know, I could have chopped his head off. That was the first thing that came through the window. He'd be running here headless, laying out there on the ground, and I'd really be sick then, you know, because I'd have killed somebody. So, I'm just glad it's over with, you know. Hopefully he learned something. He go get some medical attention because he needed.
And that's how this story ends. Ladies and gentlemen, there's not a more adorable lady on the planet. And when faced with overwhelming opposition when it came to fight or flight, she chose fight. This lady exemplifies the honey badger spirit. Ma'am, if you're out there, please contact us. We would like to send you some swag. Your bravery, attitude, and resilience is everything that is right in America. We'd love to meet and talk to you one day. Ladies and gentlemen, if you support her great attitude and fighting spirit, give this lady a thumbs up and share her story far and wide. If we don't share her story, no one else will. And I will see you the next time some numbskull picks the wrong honey badger.